very highly recommended, like Her Royal Highness. Oh.
But Grant's service pedigree includes more than a marchioness.
The Prince of Wales was looking for a butler in his household. I spent 7 years looking after him and his family.
Grant Harrold, former royal butler and etiquette expert.
Grant, good afternoon.
Michael, good afternoon, welcome.
When was afternoon tea invented?
Afternoon tea was invented around about 1840 by the Duchess of Bedford. She felt that there was a long gap between lunch and dinner, so she felt that something had to kind of fill this gap. And she came up with this idea of asking for some tea and some sandwiches.
Really good. I'm actually a bit scared.
I know. Now, I also noted that, my lady, when you actually sat down, you could have sat down almost like sitting on a sack of potatoes. So if I could actually demonstrate the fit, thank you.
She's okay.
Boy, is that a compliment.
But what it's very simple. All you do, you walk up to the chair,
yes.
You're cuffed.
You might have visitors coming to see the people that you're looking after. You might then have 11s, which we know is at 11 o'clock,
right.
Which is coffee and biscuits.
Yeah.
I can tell by that look, you know exactly what I'm talking about.
11s, oh, we have 11s here.
Fantastic.
Once we get here at 2.
I thought they did very well. One thing I noticed when they brought the tea in, you both were having Earl Grey. They say one of you was having an Assam or something. It'd be quite nice if she actually said, there's your Earl Grey, sir, and your Earl Grey, sir. Just, you know, reiterating what you're actually having.
Polite, they were efficient, they knew the selection they had. There's one or two little pointers that I've shown them that might help them out. The team that I've just met know what they're doing, very friendly. And if there is another team that's locked in a dungeon, then that's the only explanation for this mad confusion. But we'll see.
Have you ever had an oyster before?
No.
I've got no intention of having one now.
Come on.
With all of them now, how freely do the royal family feel they can speak, knowing that there is a convention that those conversations are not released to the public?
Absolutely. But the thing is, in their own home, like anybody, you're going to have a free speech. So you're going to view your personal feelings to whoever's in at your home, especially at a lunch or a dinner party.
Very strong.
it's not quite Earl Grey, but anyway, that's fine. And that's that. That's simple.
Thank you very much.
My pleasure.
Now
and thank you for introducing me to an Australian tea caddy and an Australian cow. Thank you.
Phone calls, looking after guests, calming guests down so they're not nervous when they meet royals because they kind of fall apart a little bit. It's obviously you're meeting quite famous people and they don't quite know how to behave around them.
Is it like down there? Are you like Carson?
Am I like Carson? I hope so.
We took our modest post bag to an expert to find out. Grant Harrold used to be a butler to the royals. Now he gives professional advice on the do's and don'ts of etiquette.
Christmas cards, it's the thing of who you send them to, how many you send out, what kind of scenes you have on the Christmas cards, should they be printed, are they handwritten?
Grant's advice, keep it personal and avoid putting yourself on the front cover.
As a teenager, what makes somebody want to do that?
I don't know. I think it was just seeing the kind of old movies and seeing butlers and wanting to kind of experience what that was like. And then Remains of the Day, which was a movie with Anthony Hopkins, and I saw that, and that kind of made me decide that was definitely what I wanted to do.
Grant Harrold was appointed to the highly secretive role of Royal Butler in 2004, selected by Prince Charles himself, who conducted the final job interview.
I was nervous because you're meeting one of the most famous men in the world.
You lived in the palace, you took care of their family, and also you took care of their everyday needs.
Yes.
So what were some of those needs?
It's not like the old movies, when you watch the Gosford Park or Remains of the Day, whoever you work for, you've got to be able to turn your hand to everything.
Grant Harrold knows a thing or two about Britishness. He used to be a butler for Prince Charles. He remembers meeting the prince for the first time.
And suddenly to walk into this room and he was standing there.
It's a job interview.
You think, wow, this is amazing. He put me at ease, made me feel completely
relaxed. Royal butler, is that the sort of decorum that you would expect of a gentleman?
Not really. I was a bit shocked, actually, when I saw it, because I think when he said about a reverse and dump truck, well, it's not really something you say to one of your guests at a dinner party. And I think
up in very top of Scotland, you're John O'Groats. And my brother is the king. Is the king? He wishes. Is the